back with another one, YouTube. It's me, Empress Ida, Intuitive Messenger. Okay. I did it on DJ Cali and Meg the Stallion. So it's like, stay down till you came up. You know what I'm saying? This is somebody that had their head down working. Okay, Queen of Wands. That go get an energy. Somebody that go after these options, stand in their power when it come down to these options, baby. Okay. Woo. Okay, I'm gonna take them off. Okay, first card out. It's Queen Guan, somebody standing in their power, somebody in boss mode, entrepreneur type status, working, very intuitive. When it come down to these options, this person got a lot of options coming that way, could be toxic, but this person is resting on them options, very much so tapped in. You know what I'm saying? Resting and recovering from heartbreak, could have been through a lot healing. And this star power lining things up for them to shine even brighter, okay? Offers are coming in. Small offers are coming in. Fishy offers are coming in. And people that's in these page energies. You know what I'm saying? But we got a King of Pentacles with this queen. Okay. So we got a King of Pentacles. A King of Pentacles is somebody that got their finances together. But this is somebody that's a family man. This could be a family man that's already involved. Okay, this person got a lot of love and they see this as a divine connection. This could be a soulmate connection. Okay, they want this loving relationship. They want to create abundance. They want to create, come together and create more abundance in this partnership. Okay. Bottom of the deck, they want this partnership to move forward. Okay, we still in this bitch on with T.I. Juicy J. So this person is still in it. I feel like this is this King of Pentacles. Could be an earth sign. This person could be moving away from a fire sign. We got the relationship is over. No second chances. Grow and transform your life. Okay, so somebody realized their options and they ended a situation. Yeah, coughing. So we got the Grim Reaper and we got coughing. Come out with this Queen of Wands and these options, okay? This could be somebody. So, end is bringing new beginnings, growth, change, liberation, transition. Okay, so somebody could be ending a situation, a transition to grow. And they looking at their options, their new beginning. Okay, bottom of the deck is mirroring each other, self-image, relationship, reflecting our wounds, introspection. So, I guess you walking away. Standing your power when it comes to your options, resting and recovering, healing. Now this person want to come in the same way they came in the past, and they see that the situation is over with, it's dead. It's a coffin in it. So this is making this person mirror pretty much past situations. Okay, we got healthy choices popped out over here with this rest and recovery. Making healthy choices in love and in life. Self-love, self-care, being happier. Okay, so this makes plenty of sense. Clock, need time, take time in time, cycles, time to heal, progress. So with this coming over this page of cups and this King of Pentacles, which is somebody that's involved and they don't have a lot to offer because they in the family dynamic, they want to buy more time in this situation because they got a lot of love for this situation. and they see you as the end all be all. This is somebody that want a partnership with you. They want to move forward, but this person is already involved in the situation. Yep, the snake flew out. Competition, enemy, clever, malicious. Look over your shoulder, the other woman. Okay, this person want more time, but then they dealing with a snake at the same time. Yep. Okay, all of these flip. So this person at the bottom of the deck, they want to move forward with this chariot and take a chance of risk being strategic options, not showing their hand, they gambling. So they trying to take a risk towards you while they still involved with somebody else. And they still want this situation to move forward. Golden mirror, self-absorbed, narcissist, one-sided relationship, love bombing. Okay, coming over this lover's card, this person want to come in and they want to love bomb you. Or they could, karmic relationship. Okay, so you know what? This person want to come in with you, but this is how I'm seeing this. They dealing with a narcissistic energy, or this person could be a narcissistic energy. Because we got karmic relationship fleeting triggers turmoil, resentment, lessons, letting go, and loving you. And you loving you because this situation was karmic. The only thing this person did was want to come in and love bomb and leave back out because they was already involved with somebody else, but they was involved with a snake. And now that they realize they was involved with a snake, they feel like they running out of time to come back with you, but they haven't ended what they end. Date, meeting someone new. Date, get back out there. Plan, set a date. So this is just saying when it comes down to these partnerships, you need to get yourself back out there and date. Because it's going to lead to an engagement, a partnership, commitment, eternity, completion, union. This dating is going to land you with somebody that's going to be committed. Somebody that want to motherfucking commit. Abundance is right up under that. Keep a positive mindset. Manifest exactly what you want. Gratitude, bliss. Once you get out and start dating, you going to meet somebody. Y'all going to get engaged. Abundance is going to come in and ascend and transcend the obstacles. Learning, expansion, new phase. Prepare for union. You know what I'm saying? You going to be preparing to be in your union that you supposed to be in. Okay, away from all this karmic shit. I don't even know if I want to pull nothing out. Real talk. Woo. How these cards feel. Maybe I'm supposed to trust your innocence. Maybe I'm supposed to pull these. These actually fell too. Rockstar. Maybe that person is trying to keep up a certain image. I need to fix this thing so it can zoom in on. And it's a way to zoom in on this. I'm going to figure it out. But the way it was set up the other day, you can see the cards real good. They know ain't no place like home. That's why they want to come back and try to attempt. Communication is coming in from this person. Okay? Because this person see that you got a new blueprint going because you went through this transformation of healing. And you, our ancient future, okay? So this is somebody you could have had a soul tie with, dealt with in another lifetime. But you didn't heal that situation. You moving different. You focused on your future. Tapped in with this yin and yang, balancing out that masculine and that feminine energy. Feel like complete all on your own. Adventurous. taking chances. And this adventurous fell by this lovers and date. So it's time for you to be adventurous and get back out there. Okay, we got strong about Kanye West, and we got diligence at the bottom of the deck. So I feel like this person is going to be diligently trying to come back in, okay? Because they see you going forward on your voyage in this magical, mystical-ass gateway of adventures, okay? And this person want to come through with you. They want to go on these adventures with your ass. Or, you know what I'm saying, keep going forward on this voyage through this gateway on these adventures with these new experiences with new people. Because, like the card say, it's going to end in engagement, abundance, and ascending to a higher level. And these are higher level of commitments. You know, somebody that got that same energy that you got. Okay. Like I said, on this magical, mystical adventure toward miracles, okay? Because miracles are going to happen. We got somebody that's gossiping, and these are women gossiping. But this person is feeling guilty. You know what I'm saying? That they entertain bullshit because they, we got empaths. This person is blocking them. It's a lot of secrets going on. You know what I'm saying? And the people that they gossiping with don't even motherfucking believe the shit. You know what I'm saying? Because they see what's going on. And this is causing this person to deal with a lot of guilt. Because in front of everybody, they want to be goody two-shoes with that halo over their head. But when really, they sitting in the motherfucking dark drinking. Okay? Lonely than a motherfucker because they dealing with him and all this plan type energy. And they blocking their abundance by staying in the situation trying to put on a motherfucking visual that ain't even what it really is. You know what I'm saying? Trying to paint their life to be something that it's really not because, look, she got a motherfucking chain on her arm and I ain't even noticed that. Look at that chain. And she bound by these lies. Can't even move forward because she bounded by her motherfucking lies. Depressed in the motherfucking dark. You know what I'm saying? Gossiping about all the green and the money. But shit, that shit ain't making no motherfucking happy. And still need to stand in her power and persevere. This person could be getting down low too. This wife that your masculine is dealing with. She's starting to stand on her ground and with all of this orange that just represents that sacred chakra balancing out her emotions. Okay? Looking for a miracle to come in. Trusting her instincts. Want forgiveness for the situation and could be looking for some type of recovery and want to be accepted in back in by the crowd. But like I said, all that gossip and shit, motherfucker saw straight through that shit. And now she feeling guilty because she bounded by her own fucking lies. And this masculine energy still doing him. Want to come in with this cup. Could be possibly going through a transformation, but got a lot of secrets, okay? And both of them dealing with guilt and need to persevere past some stuff. They praying, both of them. Talk to their angels. Keep talking to them. Hopefully they can heal their situation and go in whatever direction is right for them. Whether it's still together or whether it's with another person. Because I don't never try to wish nothing on nobody or try to break up nobody else's union. You know what I'm saying? If that's what make you happy, then, hey, that's what make you happy. I'm happy for you. But if you unhappy in a situation and you just gossiping because the money good, you bound yourself to that situation. And you're not even going to be able to move forward. And when really the situation ain't even what it seems. You know what I'm saying? Because motherfuckers is wild. She got on this red dress. She trying to persevere. But at the same time, being promiscuous in the dark. Being promiscuous in the dark. Drinking and being lonely in the dark. Because she's being left alone. And if I'm not mistaken, 15 is the number of a transformation. This person could be going through a transformation. And paying attention to the signs of entrapment. Oh my gosh. And I did say this person is entrapped. Let's see what else fall out. We got showstopper on. We got beauty. Unleash your creativity and love. Okay, so this person see that you wild, you untamable. You ain't finna fall for that bullshit and pretend to be happy and perfect and really you sad. You gonna show motherfuckers who you truly are. You know what I'm saying? So this person probably see you as wild, but they recognize your beauty because you unleashing that creativity and it's causing this masculine to yearn for your love. Because you see how this person is watching over this feminine? And this feminine is looking forward. Whoa! No, baby! We got patience at the bottom of the deck. So, okay, mirrors. This masculine is going to continue to come in because he praying for a miracle. He wants you to be patient, but in this picture, 8 and 2 represents 10. 10 represents new beginning. This person got a cup of wine that's spilled over, and it's a voodoo doll right here. And this masculine is in this background, and she is holding the pendulum. I don't know if I can get it clear enough for y'all to see this voodoo doll. She doing some type of spell work to keep this masculine from moving forward at night. She see your beauty and she see you unleashing your creativity. She see you fucking manifesting. And got a voodoo doll. Could be doing this stuff when she drinking. Okay? Because she see you receiving from the universe and she trying to stop that. Because you the shock motherfuckers with the shock of the new. Okay? It's sunflowers and music. And you could be communicating with your masculine through music, but this is just saying how that inner trust. You could be feeling depleted during sometimes, tired, dehydrated. That's because you got motherfuckers pulling at your energy and dabbling in black magic, but all that shit is gonna backfire. And I have been seeing my crows. I just ain't been talking about them. I showed my mom and she like, oh, that's just a coincidence. These crows came back here with two of them. I'm like, okay. We traveled to a whole nother side of town. And I'm like, you see them crows over there? Same two crows. Well, I don't know if they're the same two crows because I ain't no birdologist. I ain't, you know, I don't study animals or nothing like that. So it could have been two totally different crows. But I'm like, okay, is it a coincidence that we see two crows on the other side of town? And she looking like, like, and lo and behold, the shenanigans started. But the card is the fin to the end, the worthwhile. And I'm not finna, like, really go into the shenanigans because I'm not trying to feed that no power. Like, I was led to do that reading, and that reading was that reading. And that reading said what? It spoke volumes, point blank in a period. I'm going to leave it at that because I'm not finna give these motherfuckers no energy for throwing witchcraft at me. It's in here, too. Okay? Every journey starts with a single self. So, this is like, go on your journey and defend to the end of worthwhile. You know what I'm saying? You done been wounded. You done been through a lot. You given a lot. It's time for you to receive. It's time to receive. The perfection of your life. All that old shit is burning away for the new. You got to let it burn away. And dive for light. Because you got somebody that's diving for light towards you. And this connection is heaven sent. But you need to do what you feel. What do you feel? You can't compare this to something new. You know what I'm saying? So it is saying, get back out there. Every journey start with a step. Do what you feel, because what you want, won't you. All day long, you manifesting. Them spirals of manifestation. Release these allegiance with all these old people that's trying to sting you. Because you in the world, not of the world. You not following these fish. You motherfucking shining bright on your own. Okay? And you making these conscious connections. People notice you. You don't even notice people noticing you. You discovered your life purpose. It's the music. 29 reduced to 11. 11 is the number of balance. You need to balance yourself out so you can focus and be inspired, because this is inspiration. You got a lot of uploads and downloads coming in that you need to pay attention to. And you got people that's trying to distract you from your past. But this is saying release the dark wound and let love live. Continue to have love for what it is that you want to do. Continue to release this old shit because it's dead. And listen for truth. Real talk. Because you probably collaboratively dreaming. And what I'm getting from this card with this bitch at night, she could be coming in your dreams trying to fuck with your dream state and your third eye. You know what I'm saying? And play you like a fucking sacred fool. And redirect your big, bold vision that you got for yourself. So stay focused. And follow your own rhythm. Real talk. Because you bringing it into form. And you don't even realize you bringing it into form. That's why you need to stay focused and keep going. And relax the whole of darkness and be at cause. You know, embrace this isolation and be at cause. Because after the storm, you gonna gain clarity. This owl is holding this box. You gonna gain clarity and Pandora's gift. You gonna receive Pandora's gift, okay? And that's visions beyond death. So that's psychic abilities. You're going to find your trolls, soul tribe. Your prayers are going to be answered. That's all you need to do is just trust yourself. And I'm going to end this right here. I ain't know I was going through this. And Ghetto Dreams featuring Nas is on by Common. No matter what type of dream you got, you need to trust yourself. Because if it's something that you're passionate about and it's a gift that God put in you, it's something that you need to use that you can get monetization for. You can get paid for it. Figure out a way to get paid for it. Do your research. You know what I'm saying? Don't follow the rest. Follow your own rhythm and trust yourself. And thank you guys for listening to this. I hope this resonated with somebody. I'm Empress Ida, Intuitive Messenger. Thanks for sharing this space with me. And you guys enjoy the rest of your day.